buried in the headlines somewhere, and I'm sure rolling through cyberspace as comments and social media. Bill Maher, remember him? Real Time with Bill Maher on HBO. He took a little bit of heat for mocking folks in flyover country in the Midwest. Jim Gibson, he knows Donald Trump, and he's also quite familiar with the elitist mindset up Northeast and also on the opposite left coast. Jim, welcome to The Wall. Give me a little bit of background on you, Jim. How do you know Donald Trump? What type of business dealings you have with him?
Hey, Sergio. First of all, I'm calling you from Chicago, so let me just share with you, a lot of my neighbors are moving your way because of our taxation and issues.
Yeah,
so someday down the road, we may be neighbors. But I have a long friendship and business relationship with our now president. In the mid-90s, early 90s, I actually met him through one of your Texas guys, a guy named Jim Kelly, who went on to become the Hall of Fame Buffalo Bills quarterback.
Cool.
He was playing for the Houston Gamblers.
You know, yes, the old XFL team, yes.
Yeah, he was merging. Dr. Argovitz owned that team. Long story short, I met Jim when I hosted Miss Texas down in your area on a telecast down there. He was a judge, and we became friends. So when he was going to New York to meet Mr. Trump, now President Trump, that's where I met Donald for the first time. And in a myriad of other connections, but that was my first meeting. We became very good friends. And I, Sergio, had the unique job for 40 years of hosting most all of the telecasts for Miss Universe USA, Miss USA States, or our surrounding pageant world. So when Madison Square Gardens decided they wanted to sell the pageant, the entire package, I approached President Trump at that time and said, I think there's a great opportunity here to make a lot of money and do some great things. So that's when we became very close, and that was in the mid-90s.
You know, Donald Trump was a member of that New York elite society and Hollywood and entertainment elite society. How, when, why did they turn on him?
You know, that's a good question, because when I first met him, of course, everybody loved him. He was and anybody that's known him for a long time really knows the president. Why they turned on him, clearly, obviously, he became someone that they no longer felt they wanted to be a part of. I think his decisions, whether it be political or whether personal life, were going in directions that many of the people on the coast thought were becoming more conservative. And me being from the Midwest, I think he found great solace and having me be a part of that transition with Miss Universe and really Mid-America. Who is America? You know, he owned New York City, literally. But a lot of people only saw him, whether it be on a Saturday Night Live show or just what they read in the paper. Not all America really knew him. So in one sense, Sergio, when he became the owner of Miss Universe, we moved it from CBS to NBC, and I can share with you my CBS story with Les Moonves. That's a whole amazing thing that kind of brought me back to this Bill Maher mindset. But that's when we spent a lot of time together and really, really searched out America. And I was the Midwest guy that he chose to become the director of pageant affairs, and I helped him with that transition of purchasing from Madison Square Gardens, which is where I met the disgraced Les Moonves, former CBS television president, because he was Mr. Trump's partner in the Miss Universe deal.
When
did
you,
I lose you?
No, I was going to ask you. When you hear, were you paying attention to the Michael Cohen testimony or the circus show that took place in front of these lawmakers, these Democrat lawmakers? Were you paying attention to some of the things he was saying?
I was. Mr. Cohen came in right about the time I left the Trump Organization. I could have written a script where he was going to go. The guy clearly, I never met him. I've met a lot of people that have met him. Don't have a lot to say about him other than from the people I respect, aside from the president. I'm not a great fan of Mr. Cohen's, and I don't think a lot of people are. And yesterday he just proved a side that was pathetic.
He only goes back 10 years, right, about a decade, because your dealings with Donald Trump and other executives, That's like 20 years ago, right? That's a long time ago.
Well, yeah, he bought Miss Universe 20 years ago.
Yeah.
And I stayed with it. The only reason I left, I got married. I decided to move back to the Midwest, my roots. New York was no longer an area that if I got married, raised kids, that I thought would be the best environment. I've always embraced the Midwest values, the Southern values. That's always been where I've believed. And again, that's a very interesting story with Les Moonves. And again, it just parallels the Bill Maher egocentric way they view all of us, and I would include you in that, and not just conservatives. I don't even think this is a political thing with his mindset. I think it's just the way they look at those of us that they consider disposable people. I had to fly into L.A., Sergio, on behalf of the president to meet with Mr. Moonves and discuss the future of Miss Universe. And when I did, and I had already discussed this with now President Trump, we really wanted to embrace it as a grassroots mid-America. It's a tool for young ladies to use to get where they want to go. If you're born in L.A., you're born in New York, you're born in Miami, you're born in Las Vegas, it's fairly easy. But when you're born in Des Moines, Iowa, it's not easy. I crowned Halle Berry, for example, at a teen pageant when she was just 14 years old, and then later Miss Ohio, USA. That was a very important part of her transition to getting to Los Angeles. So I believed in that, and so did he. Donald loves making dreams come true. So when I flew out to L.A., I walked into Mr. Moonves' office, and I shared what I'm sharing with you right now. I was about halfway through, and he stopped me, and he said, Jim, I'll be honest with you. I don't care about the Midwest. We don't care about the Midwest. We care about the coast, and that's where we're going. So all of the things that we wanted to do, he totally just blew off as if, quite frankly, we're nothing to them. Just exactly the way Bill Maher spoke last Friday night. We are people that don't buy our clothes, or he would buy his clothes. And the thing that really nauseated me when he said, you know, we all just want to be like him. We want to be like those coasts. And that bothered me. So that's why I just decided I have to go on the record. Mr. Trump understands America. He understands mid-America. Yeah. That's why he was elected president of the United States. These coastal people, the arrogance, and where they're going, and more the progressives than any, that's where it's at.
There is no overcoming that mindset at all.
There really is not.
You just need to defeat it at the polling place and make sure they don't get power. But there's no way to change these people's minds. They live in their bubble, and there's nothing you can do to convince them otherwise that there's something better in America.
And even more than believing, Sergio, they are out to absolutely destroy us. When I was at the presidential inauguration, the thing I took away from that inauguration more than anything, the joy of being there and the celebration of our next president, was the amazing amount of hatred that we experienced flying home after the inauguration with all the people that were there protesting. And the same things you see, they'd knock our hats off. They'd swear at us. They'd shove us. They would say horrible things. I have my 11-year-old son with me. That's what bothers me more than they disagree with us. They absolutely hate us. And that blows my mind.
There is hate. Absolutely. That's what it is. It's nothing but hate. And it's real pathetic that all the networks decided to give so much time to this liar who did nothing but call Donald Trump a racist and a mob boss and do his part, give ammunition to the enemy and all these haters to bring out all these stupid stories, compromising stories, and lies like Donald Trump hitting his wife in an elevator at some video somewhere out there. There's no place for that. They're full of hate.
When he was running for president, I did a lot of interviews at that time because there was a lot of media about me being, you know, Donald, I was married to Mar-a-Lago. Donald and the First Lady are the signing witnesses on my wedding license. I mean, I am that close to the president of the United States at a friendship level.
Wow.
So that I did a lot of interviews about that then. And everybody, what is he really like? You know what he's really like? I don't know if I'm not a big Oscar fan, but Lady Gaga had a quote, and I don't know if you saw it, Sergio, but it almost describes the man I know and his philosophy in life as good as anything. And I'll read it to you quickly because I just saw it the other day. This is what she said. It's not about winning, but it's about not giving up. If you have a dream, you fight for it. If there's a discipline for passion, and it's not about how many times you get rejected or fall down, or as many times as you're beaten up. It's about how many times you stand up and are brave and you keep on going.
That's America right there.
That is America.
That is America.
That is the American dream. My wife, by the way, is a minority immigrant. My wife believes so strongly in what the president is trying to do. She experienced that, and it breaks her heart when she sees what we're doing now with the border wall and things that you're very involved. I mean, all of these things combined. Mm-hmm. It's not about how many. That's the one thing I would say. Two things about the Mr. Trump. Perseverance, tenacious. Those are the two words I always would use. And number three, an incredibly loyal guy. And I like those qualities in a president.
Yes, sir. He's a friend to President Donald Trump, who was TV star and at one time owner of that big beauty pageant. My guest right now, and I want to thank you for your time today, Mr. Gibson. Jim Gibson was at one time director of pageant affairs for the Miss Universe organization. What are you doing these days, Jim? Before I let you go, what are you doing? How are you paying the bills these days?
Well, first of all, I do a lot of events still. I produce a lot of special events, Sergio, around the country. Mm-hmm. I own some different. Actually, I own the Las Vegas International Model Search. If you have somebody interested in that, that's still a production I do at MGM in Las Vegas. And
I'd send you my wife, but she would beat everybody. So yeah, it'd be unfair.
it's great. It's great. And keep fighting the fight. I was listening to you earlier, and I wish I was in Texas. I really do.
Well, come on down here, buddy. The weather's nice and warm. And make sure to make it all the way to South Texas to the McAllen area, because in Dallas today, it's like 29 degrees. It's nasty.
Right? That's funny.
Thank you, Jim. Well,
all right, Sergio.
You take care. We'll talk soon.
All right, pal.
Bye-bye.